Hello everyone, welcome back to the NABARD Grade A 5-day question series. And before starting with the video, I hope you are preparing well for the examination. We are providing 10 mocks of phase 1 and 5 mocks of phase 2, that too for 999 rupees. So the gross amount is 1500 rupees and you can use the coupon code MOCKS, M-O-C-K-S MOCKS, and then can avail the discount to get these tests for 999 rupees. Do not forget to enroll for these mock tests as it will help you in your examination. Let's begin with the first question. So the first question says, what is pisciculture? Now there are different types of cultures and we'll be discussing some of the important ones over here. So pisciculture refers to the cultivation of fishes in a controlled aquatic environment. Now it's very important for you to notice over here that there are two kinds of culture, one being the aquaculture and another one being the pisciculture. So pisciculture is related to the cultivation of only fishes. It's important to note that aquaculture deals with the cultivation of aquatic organisms. Apart from this, this aquaculture is also known as the aqua farming and thus deals with the aquatic organisms cultivation. So very well known culture is horticulture. We are aware of this, and this horticulture deals with more of the garden culture. So it includes fruits and vegetables. Another very important culture is the silviculture. I asked the same question regarding the silviculture in the NABARD day 22 video. So in the previous video of NABARD, you would find that I asked in the question regarding silviculture. So basically the practice of controlling the growth, the composition and the health and the quality of forest is known as silviculture. So silviculture is related to forest, horticulture is related to fruits and vegetables, aquaculture is related to the aquatic organisms, and pisciculture is related to fishes. So it's important to note the difference between these cultures. Another question is, which of the following is the category of capture fisheries? Now before going to the answer of this question, it's important to know that the fisheries can be categorized into two types, that is the capture fisheries and another one being the culture fisheries. So one is capture and another one is culture. So capture fisheries, as the name suggests, it is basically exploitation of the aquatic organism in their natural environment, that is related to, so without stocking the seeds of the fisheries, we are capturing the fishes, that is known as the capture fisheries. And at the same time, when we are talking about the culture fisheries, so it's opposite of the capture fisheries, that the cultivation of the selected fishes in the confined area or an environment is known as culture fisheries. So more of aquaculture. As in the previous question, we discussed that aquaculture is the cultivation of aquatic organisms in a controlled aquatic environment. So that is known as culture fishery. Now there are two categories of capture fisheries, one being the marine and another inland fisheries. Where marine is related to the fishes which are captured in the oceans and seas. And inland fisheries deal with the freshwater capturing. So this is the basic difference between marine and inland, and they are part of the capture fisheries. When we talk about the culture fisheries, so culture fisheries could be done in many categories, one being the fresh water, another is the brackish water, next one being the marine cage, the ornamental fisheries, the cold water aquaculture. So these are the different categorization of the aquaculture or culture fisheries. Now this makes me come to the static question, that where is the largest brackish water lake located in India? So you need to mention that in the comment section below, that where is the largest brackish water lake located. So moving on to the next question, that is, what is the loan lending period under the FIDF created for the fisheries development? Before going to the answer of this question, you need to know that what is FIDF. So FIDF is the Fisheries and Aquaculture Infrastructure Development Fund. So this is the full form of FIDF, which has been created or set up by the Department of Fisheries, which comes under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare. It's important to note these things, that it comes under the Ministry of Agriculture and Farmers Welfare and mainly under the Department of Fisheries. Now, what is the purpose of setting up of this fund? So as the name suggests, it has been set up for the fisheries development. So this fund will be working on the target of the Blue Revolution. And what is the target of Blue Revolution? So the Blue Revolution has the target of fish production, that is 15 million tons by 2020. So this is the target of Blue Revolution, and for the same purpose FIDF has been created. Another target is 20 million tons of fish production by 2022-23. So this is the target and which needs to be achieved by this FIDF. So this fund will work on the sidelines of this Blue Revolution. Now the loan lending period under this FIDF is 5 years. So the loan will be disbursed for the 5 years, and the loan disbursement year or duration is 2018-19 to 2020-23. Now this is the loan lending, the general loan lending period, that is for 5 years. When we talk about the maximum repayment period, so what is the maximum repayment period? It is 12 years, which is inclusive of the moratorium of 2 years. So 2 years moratorium years are included in these 12 years, and so the maximum repayment for this loan is 12 years. Moving on to the similar question. So which of the following is the nodal loaning entities under the FIDF created for the fisheries development? It might seem that the answer is just NABARD, but not just NABARD, but all of these is the answer for this question. So NABARD, National Cooperative Development Corporation, and the All Scheduled Banks, these are the nodal loaning entities under this FIDF, which has been created for the fisheries development. So remember this thing, the nodal loaning entities. Now the interest subvention is up to 3% per annum for all the eligible entities. And what is the rate of interest? So the rate of interest is, the lending rate of interest should not be lower than 5%. So what all you need to remember in this question, that FIDF has been created by the Department of Agriculture. It has the target of working on the Blue Revolution, that is 15 million tons of fish production by 2020. Another, the maximum repayment is 12 years, but the normal lending period is 5 years. The interest subvention is 3% per annum, and the rate of interest should not be lower than 5% per annum for all the eligible entities. The loaning entities, they are NABARD, National Cooperative Development Corporation, and all scheduled banks. This is how we have concluded the whole of FIDF. The next question is, as per the 2017-18 final estimates, so for final estimates, the total production of horticulture crops during the year 2017-18 was, so as per the final estimates which have been recently released by the Department of Agriculture, Corporation and Farmer Welfare, the total production of horticulture crops is 311.71 million tons, which is approximately 3.7% higher than the previous year. So it is 3.7% higher than the previous year. Also, along with this final estimates of 2017-18, the first advance estimates of 2018-19 have been released, and it has been found out that the total production, horticulture production of the country is estimated to be 314.67 million tons, which is approximately 0.95% higher than the previous year of 2017-18. Similarly, the area in terms of million hectares stands at 25.43 for 2017-18, and it's 25.87 million hectares as per the first advance estimates. Now it's time for you to tell me in the comment section that what is the India's rank in terms of horticulture production. So tell me in the comment section the India's rank in terms of horticulture production. Also, do not forget to subscribe to our channel Anuj Jindal and press the bell icon as well. We'll be posting the next video soon. I hope you're preparing well for the examination. Good luck, and thank you so much for watching the video.